You played a chess world championship in 2004, and these days the chess world championship in London 2018 between Carlsen and Caruana is taking place. Tomorrow is the last round. What is your opinion about this match? So what's happening there?
Well, it's a very, very special match because when you just look at the result, you see that 11 games had been played so far and all games had been drawn. But don't be fooled by this. I mean, we have seen some incredible fight. Both players showed basically incredible skills in very, very difficult situations, keeping their calm, keeping perfect concentration throughout the games. Definitely there were missing chances. For example, Carlsen should have won the first game, and would he have won that first game, I think the whole match would be completely different. I mean, not necessarily result-wise, but the dynamics, yeah? Then maybe there would have been much, much more decisive games. However, it sometimes happens when there is a flow of draws, then doesn't matter how hard you are trying, whatever you try, your opponent will also always play very good and manage to hang on. There was this game when Carlsen managed to save a game with piece done. I mean, some opposite colored bishop position. It turned out that computer finds some incredible study-like win, but the problem during the game that you don't know which moment you have to look for something. And the general feeling was that the position is kind of a miracle positional fortress. And basically, I think it was justified that the game ended in draw. But if Fabiano would have found that bishop h4 and knight e2, knight g1, then again, we would have seen a completely different match. Then there was this ninth game, or yeah, ninth or tenth game. I mean, the tenth game was some. Or the ninth game, I already suddenly confused because I was traveling to the Bundesliga. But I mean, this Veshnikov game, when it looked like after move 20 that, okay, maybe Magnus will just mate Fabiano, and maybe Fabiano will just defend the mate and just win the game. And all of a sudden, in some very big fight, even that position ended in a draw. It's, I mean, that's what I say. One cannot blame the players. They are really giving it all. There is also a lot of nerves at stake, and we still have one more game. So at this moment, it looks like tiebreak is the most likely outcome, but I mean, those last games are always very, very tricky, not necessarily only for black. I mean, white definitely has the advantage that if he wants before the game just to secure the match and make it a tie and let's see what's happening in the tiebreak, that's what Magnus did against Karjakin in New York 2 years ago. But if you already go into a fight and you are trying to press with white, you already automatically give black chances as well. So it's a very, very tricky situation. I'm very interested to see how Fabiano will approach this game. And also to see whether, like everybody's talking about that in rapid chess and in tiebreaks, Magnus is probably the favorite because he is extremely good in all this. But this is also very tricky because this is a world championship match. I mean, those tiebreaks are not regular rapid games. And also, you know that your opponent is brilliantly prepared. You also kind of already spent 2.5 or 3 weeks together. You kind of feel each other, and Fabiano by this point definitely feels that he's at the same level as Magnus. This definitely gives him confidence. So I think the tiebreak is also completely open. And if it happens, we will witness some real dramatic events. But let's wait first for the 12th game.
We will look forward to the 12th game. You played a lot of games against Magnus Carlsen and Fabiano Caruana. Do you have an assessment? So what are the strengths of Magnus Carlsen and Fabiano Caruana? Are there some differences?
Well, basically they have one thing in common, that both of them are extremely strong. One has to acknowledge that. Basically, I had a very special moment against both of them because I haven't been playing with them lately. And I remember when Magnus was the upcoming player, And then I was also a serious top 10 player, and I had very good results against him. I think I was like plus 3 at some point, beating him in 2007 and 2008. But then at some point it turned, and I think by now we are equal already. However, with Fabiano, I'm still in clear plus score. I was one of the most unpleasant opponent for him. We played between 2010 and 2013 quite regularly. And he was already, really, it was clear that he is coming and sooner or later probably will be a challenger. But for some reason, his style and way of play suited me perfectly, and I had very, very good result. Then in 2014, he finally managed to draw comfortably against me with black. And that was the moment when I felt that, wow, Fabiano is ready to be the challenger sooner or later. And it did happen. Okay, I think both players are very, very strong, and both have incredible concentration. I mean, this is one of the toughest, because I feel like also when you are getting older, it's not that you are not able to play as good as before, but simply to keep this tension and to be able to play basically perfectly and calculate every position from first move till the end, this is when suddenly age tells. Yeah, and then it's enough basically in one game to make a small mistake and small inaccuracy, and all your work what you have been doing for the 5-6 hours before just vanishes. And those players are clearly at their top.
Yes, endurance is very important, and so both players are working out very regularly, are very physically top fit.
I think when you are trying to become world champion, you are there, you have to be super fit. Basically, if you are not fit, you will not reach there to play for the crown. It's kind of automatic. It's typical in Magnus' case. I think it's like the ideal situation. It was also like with me that I really loved doing sports. And basically, without sports, it was just impossible to imagine my life. In Fabiano's case, he also said that he is not that sportive, but he enjoys, and he knows that it's important, and he's doing a lot of physical exercise, and the games and the whole match shows that both of them are extremely fit.
Yeah. A question we got from our viewers. Where do you follow the Chess World Championship? Do you have a special recommendation, a live stream?
I think this World Championship match is covered brilliantly. I mean, there are so many platforms. I think Chess24's commentary with Swidler and Grishuk, and also with some others, it's widely known as so-called best platform. But I have also been joining the St. Louis Chess Club broadcast 2 times. I was extremely busy, but I managed to join that, and it was a lot of fun, because I know that Yasser, Jennifer and Morris are doing also incredible job. I mean, it's always a pleasure to follow their commentary, and it was nice to be part of it, and I managed to share my thoughts with them.
Thank you very much for your deep insights about the Chess World Championships. Thank you, Peter Liko.
Thank you as well.